Is that last drink one too many? Think about it. This is AFTV channels 2 and 6, Iraklion Air Station, Crete.
Hello, and welcome to Iraklion Magazine. I'm Deborah Hull.
And I'm Gil Zendejas. Take a group of Americans who are used to all the comforts of home. 50 channels of TV, shopping malls, fast food. Now move those Americans to a sleepy Greek island where they have the choice of one channel of TV and a culture so new to them they can't even say the ABCs.
Psychologists call it culture shock. They say that to acclimate, one must utilize personal adjustment mechanisms. We call it keeping it together.
And that's what tonight's show is all about. We'll take a look at some of the different ways adults keep it together, how kids keep it together, and even how cars keep it together at the auto hobby shop. Plus, a sobering look at what happens when it all comes apart.
Then, we'll take you across the eastern hills into the picturesque Valley of the Windmills and visit a woman who helps the whole base keep in shape.
Plus, the month in sports, touch and go, and much more, all on tonight's Iraklion Magazine. Stay with us.
The people, the shops, and the nightlife. It all awaits you in her Sonesis. See the part of Crete that hundreds around the world pay thousands to see. Her Sonesis. It's all part of the Crete experience. Take advantage of it.
Iraklion Magazine, keeping it together.
Gil, what do you like to do to keep it together?
I just like to curl up with a good book and relax.
You know what I like to do?
What?
Eat. Think I'll order.
You do that. We have a look at several ways that people keep it together tonight, and Mark Faco gets us started. Deb.
Ice cream.
A tour of duty overseas takes us away from an environment that we're used to. The recreational activities that were available may not be available to us anymore. Join me as I ask the Iraklion community, how do you keep it together?
I guess mainly because of my family being here with me. I think with them being here, I can pretty well cope.
I try to relax and have a good time, and I work out at the gym and run and ride a bike, stuff like that.
I try to keep active in sports. I play tennis or play football or something like that.
What kind of activities do you get involved in to keep it together?
I have two kids at home, so I go home and spend my time with my children.
How old are they?
I have a little girl that's 5 and a little boy that's going to be 2 in November.
That's a handful.
Yeah, that's 2 handfuls.
First of all, my job, working in social actions, there's always a new challenge. And being here only 10 days, this is paradise.
But I do, I like to venture out on my own. The island has so much to offer, it's so large, and you really can't see it in, say, maybe a couple weeks. You know, say every weekend, I take the map and I plot it out, and you just go see one area.
I like to try to keep myself busy all the time. I've been going to the aerobics classes. Go to the library once in a while, you know, try to read different things. Just basically try to keep myself busy doing things, always doing something.
So when I go home, I like to sit and relax and watch TV, but not really comprehend it, just stare right through it.
And it's so large, like one weekend I go to St. Nick's. Next weekend, go to Satia. Satia is a beautiful city. It's like going back in a time, all cobblestone streets.
Play with computers.
Knowing that eventually you get to leave.
At the other side of the island, I keep getting mixed up, north or the south side. And it's totally undeveloped, per se, to this side. And it's you sort of rough a little bit, but people are so much friendlier out there, too. And you just relax, kick back, relax, a little fishing village, a little Uzo, a little Rocky, you know, and take in the sights of tourists or whatever comes along. So it's...
Anybody looking for a tour guide? Some together answers from the hardworking people at Iraklion Air Station. But wait, maybe you just arrived and don't know really what to do. Let's take a look at how Tony Cole solved that problem with a little help from Greg Holmes.
Oh, it's almost 4:30 and almost the end of another duty day. But what do I do when I get home? I have to think of something before 4:30.
Excuse me, you say you're looking for something to do? Well, step right up, my friend. You've come to the right place. Yes, sir, from fun in the sun to a night on the town, it's all here at Iraklion Air Station. Now, this may sound like a commercial, but it's not. Just straightforward facts on some ways to enjoy yourself. You say you're the athletic type. Well, we've got intramural softball, basketball, volleyball, and football. Oh, you're a jogger? No sweat, because the mountain you run will make you work one up. And the aerobics class doesn't do too bad either. Yes, sir, it accommodates the men, too. I swear this isn't an advertisement. No, sir, just the facts. Iraklion has a computer club. That's right. Set yourself down and start on your own program. You say you want an adventure program? Well, check out AFRTS. That's right, television. Oh, you'd rather use your imagination. Well, check out the library. That's right, I'm talking books. But not just books. Albums and magazines, too. Are you still with me? Good. I know what you're thinking. A quiet evening with friends. Well, the Aegean Lounge may be what you're looking for. An evening of dining and dancing. No problem. You're not an indoors type, you say. Well, Iraklion Air Station has Volks marches, plus organizational activities like the Fireman's Muster. You don't like the thought of getting sprayed with water? How about skimming across the top? But these are the facts, remember. Iraklion has a marina. That's right, sailboats, motorboats, and paddleboats. Or you can forget all that and watch the water from the beach. And there's a whole lot more. Now, I've given you the facts, and only facts. So what do you say?
Could you repeat that?
I know what some people act so childish. Gee. Hi, I'm Nikki Amos. You know, even us youngsters here at Iraklion have to deal with the stressful and sometimes emotional instabilities of a new and very different environment. In other words, we get bummed out too. Oh, when we do get bummed out, there's a number of things that we can do inside. Let's play games. The American Youth Activity Center, or AYA, has a lot of fun things to do. Tom Spice is the AYA director.
We'll be able to offer more programs, more physical fitness type classes, ballet, gymnastics. We have it now, but it's farmed out to the various activities. But soon we'll have it here at the AYA, and it will involve the whole family concept, not just the kids, but family involvement through the youth to reach everybody in our community. We're looking forward to the new year. It's going to be quite prosperous. We try to strive for a strong summer program to keep involvement, because here the kids get a little bored and upset sometimes in the summertime because they don't have enough to do. We just strive to satisfy every youth possible that's here to Iraklion.
Is so popular that they even have their own weekly TV show to tell everyone what's going on.
Welcome to the AYA in Review.
Fall is on its way once again, and it's time for school to begin. Summertime at the AYA was great.
Our summer day camp was a tremendous...
They even have field trips for us so we can explore a creek. But of course, if your thing is a little slower tempo, you can always go to the library and get some studying done. Either way, it's a good way to mellow out.
Sometimes cars mellow out, too. They just stop running. When that happens, it takes the auto hobby shop to help your car keep it together. Iraklion's auto hobby shop consists of 3 MWR employees and 3 contract mechanics. Their mission isn't easy: to keep American cars on the road, 8,000 miles from the nearest American parts house. If anyone can do it, it's these folks. The three mechanics have over 80 years of combined experience. Manoli Capreas alone has worked on cars 32 years and has his own shop downtown. Nikos Sorsos worked on cars in the Midwestern United States before joining on at Iraklion. And if it seems like Mike Tarter has an unusual skill for detail, it's because he's the magic pencil behind Motorpool's quality assurance. But it takes more than mechanics to run a shop. Marcia James hired on in May to fill out paperwork and issue tools. Well, at least that's what she thought.
I did not know how to do tires. I do now.
Getting parts for American cars is a problem. Manoli and Nick are good at scouring the part shops downtown, but if it's not on Crete, your order could go from Athens to Germany to who knows where. Everyone I spoke to recommended calling a friend in the States and having them mail what you need. But even without easy access to parts, it's pretty amazing what the crew can do with a little ingenuity and a lot of skill. Because that's how Iraklion's auto hobby shop keeps it together.
If we can't fix it, it's not broken.
The auto hobby shop can fix just about anything on wheels except these. These are the result of too much alcohol, not enough care, or both. For instance, no one wants to get caught behind a big smelly bus. The first chance you get, you try to pass, right? That's what happened to this Camaro. When its driver tried to pass a bus, it encountered another bus the hard way. The driver survived because of a seatbelt. This driver was only trying to avoid hitting a dog. So was the driver of the car coming the other way. Well, it was the dog's lucky day, but two people ended up in a car crash. This kind of thing happens a lot in rural areas, like anywhere on this island. This one's a classic. You have an appointment, and you're gonna be late. The only thing on your mind's the clock. Well, that's what happened here. And just this once became one time too many. Luckily, all the drivers so far were wearing their seatbelts, and they got out safely. But the driver of this Trans Am wasn't nearly as fortunate. Early one morning a year ago, he was racing down the twisting road to Hersonesus at about 80 miles an hour. He lost control, his car went over a cliff. It tumbled to a stop over 400 feet from where he left the road. His buddy said he'd been drinking, but he figured he could handle it. He won't get the chance to tell us his side of the story because he was killed in the accident. Tonight's show has been about keeping it together. But no matter how together you are, you won't stay that way for long if you're not careful behind the wheel. We'll have more Iraklion Magazine in a moment.
Why so many older movies on AFRTS? Because of the States, most movies play in theaters before they're seen on TV. After stateside telecasts, movies are made available to overseas TV stations, including AFRTS. Although it may take a year or longer before you see a film after it's shown on stateside TV, AFRTS still provides you the best movie entertainment available each week.
Taping tonight's Iraklion Magazine in Hersonesus, which will close soon for the winter.
Tonight on the Great Island, Steve Hull takes us to a place you can visit all year round.
If you ever wanted to find a symbol for Crete, you wouldn't have to look very far. There's the sea, olive groves, brilliant flowers. Then there are the windmills. You see them turning gracefully against the south winds, white sails bright in the sun. You see them in front of hotels, on postcards, in endless souvenirs. And in Lesithi, you see more than anywhere else. That's why it's called the Valley of the Windmills. The plain of Lesithi is located in the center of eastern Crete, due south from Malia. From the base, take the new road 5 miles to the Castelli turnoff, and follow the signs to the plateau of Lesithi. Plan on about a 45-minute drive. Lasithi is a plateau completely surrounded by mountains. Irrigation canals dating back to Venetian times crisscross the plain, fed by thousands of shallow wells, and of course, the windmills. The windmills are a classically Cretan expression of form and function, taking advantage of free energy to pump water to the surface. At one time, the windmills numbered over 6,000, but year by year, they're being replaced by more efficient but less picturesque electric pumps. All the more reason to make your trip soon. But there's more to Lasithi than windmills. The plain is rich with history. Take the road that circles the valley to the village of Sikro. From there, it's a short but rigorous hike to the Dictaean Cave, the legendary birthplace of Zeus. We weren't allowed to take the minicam in, but you can explore the cave to your heart's content for a small fee. Our party elected to take the donkeys back down the hill, a trip that was worth the price of admission all by itself. On the northwest side of the plain, you'll find the Vidyani Monastery, named after the family that built it in 1854. Destroyed during the Ottoman occupation, portions have been rebuilt, and even today serve as a center of worship for local villagers. By all means, enter and look around, but do so quietly and with respect. The elders of Lasithi are well acquainted with war. Many fought valiantly against the Nazi occupation in World War II. Memorials erected in Lasithi villages stand as mute testimony to the heroism of the Cretan resistance. Today, windmills occupy the plain, a modern symbol of peace, of honest people working the good earth, and keeping it together on the great island. Tonight, Deborah Hull spotlights a woman who helps people keep it together in a different way.
Iraklion Air Station in shape? Someone with boundless energy, incredible endurance, and beautiful form. Meet the fittest woman on Crete, Tina McAdoo. Tina is a senior airman working at the 6931st Electronic Security Squadron. And like many others on base, she works a hectic schedule. Four swings, followed by four mids, and then 4 days before she gets a four-day break. She often ends her workday when most of us are still in bed dreaming tomorrow's hopes. She divides her time between a full-time job, an aerobics class that meets 5 times a week, a daily workout with weights to add strength and definition to well-toned muscles, and a jog to jolt and maintain her stamina. She has an intellectual regimen as well, 3 university courses this semester, encompassing library aid, Middle Eastern politics, and physical science.
Why did you choose such an active schedule?
I've always been like that. I need to be involved. It drives me nuts if I don't have anything to do or places to go. I love keeping appointment books and having schedules that most people would say there's no way you can do it.
How did you get involved in aerobics?
The gym asked me if I would try and make some kind of a schedule that they could tell other people that I was having a class, you know, at that certain time. And so it started out with about 6 people. Like, when I got here, there wasn't an aerobics class, and I've always been used to having one wherever I've gone. So I decided that I'd go work out in the gym, and I asked some people if they wanted to go work out with me and told them I'd be there. So it started out as a very, very small class. Especially since we're in the service, you know, everyone has to be really weight conscious, and everyone's always trying to find a way to exercise that's a little bit easier than just going out and running. I think that they like the music, and it helps to be around other people exercising. You don't get so tired, and it's almost like something that you can plan on every day to do a change in pace for the day.
Everybody, work your body, my body, everybody, work your body, my body, my body.
very drastically has changed your life besides aerobics, especially in the past few months.
I know, I just got married. It's wonderful.
Chris McAdoo shares his wife's enthusiasm for fitness. They spend a lot of time together at the gym. Eventually, Chris and Tina would like to own a spa in Florida near their hometown. The couple grew up just 70 miles from each other, he in Sarasota, she in Fort Myers. They're both very close to their families, and having each other makes the family separation a little easier to bear. Tina isn't leaving Crete for another year. Plenty of time to sleek down and perk up any tired, sagging muscles needing attention at Iraklion Air Station. If you need a more stylized routine, Tina can suggest exercises to tone up specific areas. Look around. The base is looking good, thanks to Tina McAdoo, who makes it her business to keep it together. Gino Plyler looks at fit athletes who make it their business to win, next on this month's Sports Wrap-Up.
On the Iraklion sports scene this month, it was time for the Ironman competition and the action on the Iraklion gridiron. The Ironman competition was the Iraklion triathlon, or at least the biathlon. The tri portion was wiped out by the rough waters at the base beach, eliminating the swimming competition. So the athletes would tackle the two remaining events, three laps around the base on the bikes, and two laps on foot. Coming in first on the bikes was Wade Lozian, who took control early and never looked back at the rest of the field. Coming in second was Lieutenant Mark Calley. Wade had a big lead over Mark in the running competition, but Calley would not give in. He was making up time fast and was confident, saying he would catch Wade and win the title. And that's just what happened, sports fans. Mark Calley turned the last corner in the lead and crossed the finish line with a winning time of 41 minutes and 41 seconds. Lozian came in second, and taking home third place honors was Mr. Terry Crawford. The 1985 Iraklion flag football season kicked off on September 16th, and this year nine teams took the field, led by the men of ISS Communications. The action this year is wide open and features the talents of all pro players like Chris Miller, Scotty Neer, Mark Joe Willie Yoakum, Lewis Fayetteville Lopez, Larry King, Ricky Triplett, and Jeff Tornado Williams. It may not be tackle football, but the plays are just as exciting and sometimes just as physical. In other sporting news, the base basketball teams are busy getting in shape every day for at least an hour for the upcoming season. Slave driver Julie Johnston gets the players in tip-top physical condition with an aerobics course that would make anyone sweat and complain. For the football fans, the picks of the week kicked off a brand new season. The prognosticating experts of AFRTS and the base hospital got things going and were helped out by the fire department, MWR, the security police, and the Minotaurs basketball squads. We'll have the picks all season long and also a championship party for the lucky winners. As the summer season comes to a close, it's also time to say goodbye to a few Iraklion Minotaur athletes and also say thanks for the good times. A look at the sports scene on Iraklion Air Station for the month of September. Next month, it's more flag football. Of course, we'll have the picks of the week and a special look at Iraklion's own world-class Taekwondo expert. Whatever you do, sports fans, don't miss the highlights.
Now, a look back at the summer's activities. Touch and Go begins with a look at a special group that gives the rest of us good reason to keep it together. The Island View Steakhouse hosted the first annual prenatal birthday party. It was a time for the couples who had attended the classes to show off their ever-growing accomplishments.
There are a few more people who can show off with a hard-earned degree. 12 people earned their associate's degrees this summer through the Community College of the Air Force, and three more skyrocketed their educations into master's degrees.
Masters of a different kind, Scout Masters, used the Memorial Day weekend for a three-day Boy Scout camporee. The boys were treated to some friendly competition in a few events, including wood chopping, foot races, and, of course, making a fire without matches.
Boy Scouts are taught to watch their fires closely and control the flames. Earlier this summer, an uncontrolled fire threatened to destroy an entire complex and base housing. The disaster was averted with the immediate response of the fire department. The firefighters extinguished the threat within 6 minutes, saving the homes of several grateful families.
Grateful listeners got a chance to thank their favorite DJs in person when Don Tracy and Gene Price visited the island. Their expertise is in radio, but they know how to handle themselves in front of a television camera.
You can also ruin America's reputation with all of Europe through thoughtful, thoughtless thought. We'll do it over.
And of course, party with the best in Europe. See Crete. Wow. See. See.
Yeah, keep up the good work and see you at the club.
But the two pros were speechless when a few of the local AFRTS talents decided to give them a taste of the med.
Get out of the way.
You ever heard Jerry Reed's record, The Bird? I'd like to dedicate one to all these guys here who threw me in the water.
Two other notables were dunked that day, Colonel Bill Spacey and Senior Enlisted Advisor Chief James Alwell. Just an informal goodbye before the final retreat ceremony, bidding farewell to our base commander and the chief. Colonel Spacey is now with the headquarters IG in Ramstein.
The change of command ceremony introduced the base to Colonel Michael Tagaris, and one of his first official functions was to open the 4th of July festivities.
But I ask you, while we are enjoying these events of today, that we remember and think of all of the Americans in the past who have sacrificed so that we can have a 4th of July and something to celebrate.
The celebrations began with a parade complete with floats of a patriotic theme.
And what could be more patriotic than a 4th of July clown juggling machetes?
Warning, warning. Whoa. Okay. Who's going to catch it? Hey, all right.
There was also a fun run that day of 3.8 grueling miles. Fun was etched on the faces of two arch rival runners, Mark Calley and Dwayne Jenke, as they finished neck and neck.
This song by The Chords was hot on the charts back in 1955, the year Mr. Chris Gertis joined AFRTS Iraklion. We weren't much but a building then, and Chris's maintenance expertise was instrumental in taking us from radio to black and white television to color.
Next month, Chris Gertis retires from a distinguished 30-year career with AFRTS Iraklion. Chris, we'd like to say thanks, and we'll miss you. You're definitely family.
And that puts the finishing touches on tonight's show. Thanks for watching us watch you on the picture pages of Iraklion Magazine. Good night.
Night.